Here it is. Today I shall discuss the art of sources, of course from a physical chemistry point of view. So let's begin by looking at this picture. It's a picture taken in a restaurant in the 50s or 60s, and what you see are tournes d'eau, very well grilled, with the fat around, as it should be, some pommes allumettes, which are very thin French fries. It is over a salad, and nearby you have a wonderful vol-au-vent. Vol-au-vent is something very special because there is a crust, and inside you have a lot of various items. And on the top, of course, you have the béarnaise. The béarnaise is a wonderful sauce. I should say that this one is a béarnaise with butter compared to the béarnaise with oil, but it's a detail. Indeed, the sauces were performed by cooks for a very long time. Here you have one of the oldest French culinary book, the Viandier from Taïwan, 14th century. And in this book, what you see, for example, at the chapter with fish, you see the recipe for fish, which is very short. You cook with water and salt, and you add a sauce verte. And what is a sauce verte? You take some bread, parsley, ginger, you grind, you add some verjus or vinegar, and that's all. So you see, sauces were very common. In the same book, you have a very interesting recipe from vinaigrette or dressing. So you see, you begin with fish, onions, lard, bread, spices, and you boil, and you have a thick sauce. It should be brown in this case. Now I move to Carême, because Carême was very famous for sauces. Marie-Antoine Carême, he was living after the French Revolution. And you see, this sentence says that during the making of a sauce mayonnaise, so mayonnaise means vinegar, egg yolk, oil, plus salt and pepper, and you make an emulsion. Carême wrote, "You have to rub the wood spoon around the vessel to make the sauce white and firm." At that time, it took 15 minutes to make a mayonnaise. And now, with a fork, I measure recently that I need only 47 seconds. So you see, here is Carême, here is his famous book. There are many, many other details about sauces. And here are the French classical sauces. So you see, 451, and it's a mess, of course. Nobody can use this list. So what should we do? Obviously, we have to make some order in order to recognize families and so on. And at the beginning of the 20th century, it was said that you could classify the sauces by emulsion, or you bind with bread or flour or egg or blood. But indeed, it's not a very good classification. I mean, it's a bad classification, because you have in different categories the crème anglaise and the béarnaise, and both are made from the same kind of phenomena, which means that we need something else. And this is what I proposed some decades ago, to use a microscope and to look at the physical chemistry constitution of sauces. And for example, emulsions are oil droplets dispersed into a liquid in blue, and they are covered with proteins and phospholipids in general. So you see, this is an emulsion. I know that many chefs confuse emulsion with foams, but foams are very different. They are air bubbles, or any gas, dispersed into an aqueous liquid. Of course, at the limit of the bubbles, you have also some molecules, and for example, whipped egg whites, you have proteins, because an egg white is made of 10% protein and 90% water. Now you have another kind of system, which are suspensions, tiny solids dispersed into water. This is what you see here in Hollandaise or Bernese, I don't remember. Perhaps you can see one or two air bubbles. Don't consider them because they were only introduced during the preparation of the microscopy. And now we have to be systematic. We can disperse a gas, into a liquid, into a liquid disperse into a gas, a liquid, in a solid, or a solid disperse into a gas, a liquid, and a solid. When you disperse a gas into a gas, you don't have a dispersed system. You just have a gas, so it's not very interesting. By the way, culinary speaking, it's not very interesting as well. Now, if you disperse a gas into a liquid, then you make a foam, and this liquid can be water or oil. And here I should add that for physical chemists, water can be any aqueous liquid. For example, wine, orange juice, tea, both, anything that contains some water. So you can make an aqueous foam, but you can make as well an oily foam. Okay. Now, when you disperse the gas into the solid, you make a solid foam. For example, meringue. Meringue, you see, when you evaporate completely the water, now you have a solid foam. Air bubbles disperse into a solid. Let's move to the second, to the third column. We disperse a liquid into a gas. This is what we do when we spit. We have a liquid aerosol, not very interesting for cooking, but when you disperse a liquid into a liquid, you can make an emulsion. For example, mayonnaise is an emulsion of oil droplets into the water that comes from vinegar and egg yolk. An egg yolk is 50% water, and vinegar is 90%. Now you can disperse a liquid into a solid and you make a gel. Most food are gels. For example, you yourself are a gel, because you see, you are made of 80% water and you don't flow. This is a gel. Of course, you have the bones, which are perfectly solid in the middle. Let's move to the last column. When you disperse a solid into a gas, you have a solid aerosol, a powder that would blown up into the air. Now, a solid into a liquid. This is a suspension. We have seen it. And a solid into a solid, we have a solid suspension. Of course, some sources are more complex. For example, for this one, you have air bubbles, some tiny microscopic gels, oil droplets, solids, all this in water. So you see, they can be complex, and this is why in 2001 I proposed to use letters G for gas, W for water, O for oil, and S for solid. And you have some operators. I make them more clear here. You see, operators disperse into coexistence of two faces, inclusion and overlaying, and one is missing, which is when you make a gel. But now, when you apply that to the long list of French classical sauces, you can recognize, for example, emulsions, but you can recognize many things. For example, this was the corpus, so I make a big table, I use the microscope for months, and now the result is the following. For French classical sauces, we have only 23 categories. The categories are order by order complexity here, you see, and all of them are not present, which means that we have possibilities for invention. And now the question is, why only 23 categories? So when you look at the number of physical chemistry categories of sources in function of time, please don't consider the blue dot on the left, it's for Apicius, it's not French, but when you consider only French culinary book, you see the number was rising, but now, of course, when you can make any formula, any sauce, so you see the possibilities are infinite. And this is why we have plenty of room to make new sauces with new flavor, with new consistency. And I'm finishing with this picture of Hermes, the god of chemistry, speaking to Bacchus, the god of good food. And the title on top means, "Let's work." And you have my email if you want to comment.